Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching yet another episode of Eric Lehman Shenanigans of 1977. It's Thursday night, and you know what that means. It's time for your TNA Event Center Wrestling Report. And now here's the man to give you that report, Mr. Eric M. Lima.
Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer, sir. Well, hello there, everyone. Welcome to yet another episode of Eric Lehman Shenanigans of 1977, episode 1642 of the show. Pleased to have you here again, and hope you guys are having a wonderful, blessed Friday, or Friday, or Fri-pay, if you're getting paid, you know, Fri-pay, you know. Well, I officially have done it. I have pre-ordered the digital copy of the Marvel vs. Capcom Fighting Collection, available September the 12th. And it will be in 13 days. So in 13 days, I'll be able to play some Marvel vs. Capcom Fighting Collection. And I promise you, I think Shenanigarcade is in order. I'm going to try to see if I can pick up a few more things to help me do that. But right now, it's been pre-ordered. I've already pre-ordered the physical copy. That will come in November 22nd. So got my bases covered as far as Marvel vs. Capcom Fighting Collection. All I can do is wait 2 weeks. So that's all I had to do, and we'll be good to go. So last night we did Rant and Rave. Like I said, I was having fun talking to Brandon Martin and Jordan Little once again. And Jayton Long, I would like to welcome him back. I know he was under the weather the past few days or so. And but still is good. And House of Rebellion, a.k.a. Dan Rodriguez, likes to be the wisecracker in the live chat every single time. And we have a lot of fun. We talked about picks and predictions for our back-to-back PLE events. That would be the Bash in Berlin tomorrow afternoon and NXT No Mercy. So we'll have a lot of fun on that. But we got to talk about the final TNA before Emergence that's happening tonight. So am I going to watch it? Well, maybe, maybe not. We'll see what happens. But I can... For the Emergence pay-per-view, I usually never do picks and predictions for TNA Emergence unless it's hard to, you know, because TNA's got, you know, Friday their pay-per-views on Friday, unfortunately, and that's when I watch SmackDown and AEW Rampage, so a little bit too much. But what I can do is, if I have some free time, I'll probably watch the Emergence pay-per-view on a separate day, and on the next episode of a TNA Event Center, I'll give you the results and then the fallout from that a week later. I can do that if I want to. So that's the ability of having an internet and everything else sometimes, you know, but if you don't have an internet signal, that's going to be tough. So right now, I want to talk, you know, about what happened last night, the final TNA before Emergence. And we come to find out that the title match between... The title match between Nick Nemeth and Josh Alexander will be one hour Iron Man match. You know, I look at the Nick Nemeth and Josh Alexander. Josh Alexander reminds me of Bret Hart, and Nick Nemeth reminds me of Shawn Michaels. It's sort of like that, you know, like the WrestleMania 12 Iron Man match. So, I see it. I kind of see it. So, let's talk about the X Division title on the line in this matchup. As you know, whoever wins this matchup could change the Ultimate X. As you know, the X Division title will be on the line. Right now, Mike Bailey defending the title against Rich Swann. And, you know, a lot of people are jumping to conclusions about Rich Swann. Because for those of you who, who are not in the know, Sue Young got her face hurt during a wrestling match. What happened was a wrestler... it was on a video. A wrestler carelessly grabbed a steel chair and flung it at Sue Young, and the bridge of it hit her right in the face here. So she had to have, you know, and she's been hurt, and she's been out of wrestling for a while. We don't know when she's going to come back. That's the unfortunate part. And for those, there's a GoFundMe page for her, created and organized by Faye Harris, a.k.a. Faye Jackson. So, you know, she's good friends with Sue Young, so... they want to help him. Plus, you know, and everybody's jumped to the conclusion that did Rich Swann hit her again? And as you know, Rich Swann did get arrested a few years back But, you know, it seems like people don't want to forget. People, you know, when it comes to crimes perpetrated against people or something like that, or people, you know, making dumb decisions, now, people don't want to forget that. Dude, let it go. It happened. He served, you know, and that, you know, if Rich Swann was actually hurting Su Yung again, he'd be off TNA TV. He'd be fired from TNA. Right now, he was on TNA last night, contending for the X Division title against Mike Bailey. AJ Francis was joining on commentary, and Zachary Wentz and Trey Miguel were watching the matchup. Zachary Wentz is 1/6 of the competitors for the X Division title, Ultimate X. And as you know, Zachary Wentz has got a big weekend coming up. Not only that, that matchup is tonight. Trent Seven and AJ Francis. AJ Francis trying to get involved. Trent Seven came down to make sure nothing else happens, and then they were brawling during the matchup, but it distracted Rich Swann. Mike Bailey took advantage, and Mike Bailey did retain his title. And then GML interviewed Jordynne Grace as her matchup against Ash by Elegance. And a match by Elegance, basically, it's like a, I don't know, feminine street fight or something. Like, I don't know. But anyways, Joe Hendry went one-on-one with Brian Myers, and then Joe Hendry addresses Brian Myers before the match and said, respect. You know what to call him? Edge's bitch. I'm like, oh, here we go again with that. Mike Santana did show up after the matchup as Joe Hendry did defeat Brian Myers. Joe Hendry's got a huge match coming up this Sunday. NXT's, No Mercy. So, for the NXT title, I know he's got part of an 8-man tag going against the system, I believe. The Hardys, Joe Hendry, and Mike Santana going up against the system. And Mike Santana went one-on-one with Eddie Edwards. And Edwards trying to hide behind his wife. Mike Santana ended up winning that matchup. So, looks like the system has not been doing very, very well in one-on-one matches. Matt Cardona claims he's not medically cleared to compete at Emergence. And Santino Morella's confronting him about this. And he says, I got a replacement, my own personal monster. Dude, if you want your titles back, you fight PCO. I think you ticked off PCO. You disrespected him at his wedding. You disrespected him during his honeymoon. I mean, dude, you're scared of, you know, Matt Cardona, say you're scared of facing him. You know, say you're scared. Say, listen, I'm scared of facing the PCO. I wouldn't want to mess with PCO. I mean, if PCO is having his wedding and honeymoon, I say I'm staying out of this one. I would support PCO. I like PCO. But Matt Cardona is scared of PCO. He's scared. He's frightened. I'm not buying this medically cleared to compete yet. I'm not buying it. Matt Cardona is trying to weasel his way out of this. Come on. You got a championship for a time. If you have an opportunity for a championship, even though the guy is holding the title and you're... And even if you're scared of him, I would say, listen, I may be scared of him, but he's got titles that I want, and I'm going to take it. I'm going to take this fear and motivate myself to beat him for the title. No, I'm not medically cleared to compete. To say you're scared. You're scared. I think Santino Morella is not buying it either. He's not buying it. And I don't blame Santino Morella. Well, Eric Young went one-on-one with Hammerstone, and Steve Macklin was joined on commentary, and then he decides to argue with Eric Young. The two were arguing, but then the distraction did cost Eric Young. Eric Young lost to Hammerstone in that matchup. Cody Deaner and Jake Shelton addresses ABC before the matchup. ABC went up against Cody Deaner and Jake Shelton. ABC won the match, but then First Class attacks ABC after the matchup, but then Jake Shelton just watches and then walks away. I think Jake Shelton is about to become a heel, a bad guy, and I'll tell you one thing, that will not be good. And I think him and Cody Deaner end up going one-on-one. George Iceman was talking to the Militia. That's TNA Knockouts Tag Team Champions. Monster Slamovich and Alicia Edwards for the match by Elegance, which was the main event matchup for the TNA Knockouts title. Basically, it's anything goes. Weapons are involved. But it's like the elegant version, like pink and white and all that good stuff. But then Then trouble starts happening. George Iceman, the personal concierge of Ash by Elegance, gets involved. Rosemary came out, spears Ash during the matchup, and then chases George Iceman away from the matchup. The militia tries to attack Grace, and then Spitfire comes to even things up. And Jordan Grace picks up on the opportunity, pins Ash by Elegance. Still, your TNA Knockouts champion. And like I said before, there's a face-off between Nick Nemeth and Josh Alexander. Matthew Raywell was moderating it, and both men went back and forth. And it seems like, to me, Nick Nemeth is very passionate about keeping the title. Josh Alexander's question is, you know, basically disrespecting him. So, like I said, it's going to be a 60-minute Iron Man match. So, you kind of like it. Look at that. Like I said, it reminds me, this matchup will remind me of Bret Hart, Shawn Michaels, WrestleMania 12. If you think about it, Nick Nemeth, the only difference is Nick Nemeth is in the Shawn Michaels role, but the only difference is Nemeth's the champ. And meanwhile, Josh Alexander is in the Bret Hart role, but the only difference is Josh Alexander is the challenger. Bret Hart was the champion, Michaels was the challenger. That's the only difference I can gather. So, hey, it'll be a heck of a matchup. So, that will be the final TNA before Emergence tonight. We'll see what happens. I know there's a lot of matches on the card. Who is going to be the mystery opponent for PCO? We'll find out. And hopefully down the weekend. So, I have a lot to do this weekend. You know, so, I'm going to have to play some catch-up when I get home and all that good stuff. So, we'll see what happens. So, that's all the time we have on the show. On the next episode, the game of strategy, luck, knowledge, and daring, Bullseye, is back for Fearless Friday. And it'll be the 103rd episode of that as well. Thank you for tuning in. And until the next episode comes rolling around, Mr. Announcer, take us home. That is all for today's episode. This is your announcer speaking for Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977. A big beefy E, door for Bob Saget Productions, and in association with Raven Bofa Telepictures and Distribution. Thank you for watching today's episode. Tune in next time for another episode of Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977. Goodbye for now.